It's Christmas time. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my short Advent time stories. The playful Apple iBook G3 series debuting in 1999 always had a soft spot with me, and so I was very happy when I could acquire the Key Lime iBook earlier this year, completing my clamshell iBook collection. So the question is, what to install onto it? I have a plethora of Macs running on OS 8 and 9 and even OS 10. So why not trying another contemporary OS? Why not try Linux? Why not try Yellow Dog Linux? Yellow Dog Linux was created in 1999 by Terra Soft Solutions, who brought 7 major releases throughout its lifetime, with version 7 in 2012 marking its end. What made this special was not only that it was a Linux distribution optimized for the PowerPC CPU, but built specifically around compatibility to the Mac PPC platform, from the good old Power Macintosh 7200 up to the then emerging G3 and G4 platform. And what made it even more special was that in 2002, TerraSoft actually struck a deal with Apple, which allowed them to resell Apple systems with Yellow Dog Linux pre-installed. However, that deal came to be, as only the year prior, Apple had officially released their Unix-based desktop operating system to replace the dated OS 9, macOS 10.0 Cheetah. Whatever led Apple to allow this sort of competition? Maybe they didn't think it was big competition but just a niche. Or it was a strategic choice to give the impression of not hindering competition.
So it's time for a third transition, and yes, it's true. We are going to begin the transition from the PowerPC to Intel processors, and we are going to begin it for you now and for our customers next year.
Or, as it was only 3 years prior, Apple's announcement to switch over from PPC to the Intel architecture, they think it really didn't matter. Or they were happy to have a working Unix-like operating system, as the initial OS 10.0 was plagued by stability and performance issues. Whatever it was, TerraSoft had a deal, although the days for the PPC platform were maybe already starting to count at this point in 2002. Speaking of Yellow Dog Linux, the best source to retrieve nowadays is archive.org. I chose to go with release 3.0, which comes on 3 CD-ROMs. Booting it up is just as simple as pressing the C key after powering up, which will end up at the bootloader prompt, where you can choose either between a graphical and a text-based setup. Let's go graphics, right? We're on a Mac. It may look out of place seeing the Linux kernel messages scrolling by on a Mac, and even in the early phase, mentioning the Anaconda installer gives it away, Yellow Dog Linux is based on Red Hat Linux. After selecting the keyboard settings, you can select whether this is going to be a desktop or a developer system or even a server. I'll go with a desktop system. If you want, you can go for the manual partitioning, but I'm really curious how the auto partitioning will deal with the pre-existing drive setup. Okay, not too much fuss, it just replaces everything. Let's go ahead, which will lead us through the bootloader selection, the network and firewall configuration. We'll also deal with the language options, the time zone, and eventually be setting up the root account and the first user account. Note the latter, as there's a pitfall there. Eventually, the package selection comes up, though I won't mess around with it too much and just go with the defaults. Let's start the washing machine. What's a bit obscure is that it'll only ask for the video configuration at the very end of the setup process. I would have expected this earlier on, but anyway, one reboot later I'll end up with some finishing tasks before I can head into Linux. And remember what I said earlier about the pitfall. I had created an account named TPC, obviously in all capital letters, but apparently it wasn't working no matter if I tried it in all capitals or all lowercase. So I had to log in as root to begin with, and when checking the /etc/password file, indeed the account was missing. I then created it, so I can now use an unprivileged account for demoing this system. And so I ended up with a fully running desktop system that comes already with a plethora of utilities, games and applications pre-installed. It even comes with OpenOffice.org 1.0, the open source fork of Star Division's Star Office, which takes quite some time to load up. It's maybe a little bit too heavy for this dated year 2000 iBook. But I think it's definitely worthwhile exploring a bit deeper into alternative operating systems for the Mac. Or what do you think about it? Did you even use Yellow Dog Linux back in the day, and what was your experience? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my short Advent Time story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again tomorrow.